श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णु गुरुर्देव महेश्वर गुरु साक्षात् परब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः द वाइज एंड द अदरवाइज द वाइज सीज नो बडी एज अदरवाइज इन दिस वर्ल्ड And otherwise sees nobody wise in this world. How simple it is. So, Pashyanti Dehi Vanmudaha Sharira Abhasa Darshanat. The fools, when they observe a wise man, they start thinking, oh, he is just like us. Eats, sits, talks, sleeps, runs, shouts. He has the diseases. He counts money. What is the difference between him and me? Once I went in Shimla to somebody's house, a Sindhi family, and the old lady took me to their house for dinner. I don't visit people's place without purpose. So, when I went to their house for dinner, the moment I entered, I experienced very funny tension in the house. I said, hey, something is wrong in this house. Anyway, what can I do? So that lady said, Swamiji, you'll have to sit for 10-15 minutes. By the time I eat the food, I said, okay, mama. And then, watching around, I started the TV. And those days, in India, TV had come new. So, I was watching some Hindi filmy songs. And when this was seen, like the rats coming out of the holes, all the kids from the house came out from the windows. And slowly, I said, hey, come on, everybody came. And then I said, hey, who is this singer? Is she Madhubala? Oh, no, Swamiji. No, it's not like that. And slowly, slowly, the eyes thawed. We became very good friends. Food came. Then from my plate, I gave everybody one bite. They were thinking, I am a great, simple person giving from his own thali. But the real reason was, I wanted to test whether it is safe or not. So, after giving food to all of them, then I started eating. And when everything was over, we were sitting with ice cream. So, one boy asked this question, Swamiji, you and me, what is the difference? You ate from the same plate, I ate from the same plate. You sat on the sofa, I sat on the sofa. You are watching the TV, I watch the TV. You like cinema songs, I like cinema songs. Then why Dadi Ma does namaskar only to you and not to me? Very serious problem. So I said, you ask her. So he asked her, you don't know answer, Shesham Kopena Pure, become angry. This is the simplest way to answer any question. Don't ask nonsense question. This is not the way. Because I don't know. The main idea is this. Then I said, look here, Mama, it's not like that. What he is asking is true. There is no difference between average man and a wise man. They are the same. Body-wise, eating-wise, sleeping-wise, same. Only differences. Then I asked that boy, when you study, are you able to focus on studies all the time? What happens in your case? When you study, you remember the cricket. When you are playing the cricket, then you remember your friend. Your friend has not come. When you are with your friend, then you remember you are not completed the homework. When you are sitting for the homework, then you remember you have to go for a movie, but mommy doesn't agree. Is it not? How do you know? I said, forget about that. The difference between you and me, simple people, and the wise people is this. When they eat, they eat. When they talk, they talk. When they sleep, they sleep. When they work, they work. When they study, they study. When they listen, they listen. Whatever, whenever they are doing, they are available 100%. Are you like that? See, friends, this is the only difference. Our condition is, our mind is, as if, you know, one man has two wives, and one wife is pulling him this side, other man, wife is pulling him other side. What will be the condition of that fellow? Jarasandha. He will be torn into two. In the same manner, our mind is never available to us. Therefore, here the teacher says, Pashyanti Dehivan Mudhaha. Fools look upon the wise people. Oh, what is the difference between them nicely moving in the cars and then nicely going in the first class AC? What we see the wise people is the finished product. Before the vehicle comes on the road, see what it has gone through. All the parts are made, hammered, polished, fixed, and what we see is the final product. In the same manner, the Mahatmas that we see, they are the final product. Before that, what they have gone through, the chisel and the hammer treatment, that we don't know. Therefore, here, Mudaha Dehivan Pashyanti, because Sharira Abhasa Darshanat. Sharira Abhasa Darshanat means what? It appears as if they are living as the body. Because they are also hungry, they also feel cold. Our notion is what spirituality? When others are having cold, this man doesn't feel cold. It's a question of training. See, friends. Therefore, what is their life like? Example is given. Ahi nirvalayani iva. You must be knowing, after every 6 months, the snake gives away the false skin. We also change our skin, but we don't know, because we rub it with the soap and it is thrown away. The snake, his whole skin becomes old, and it is, he wants to discard that. So what the snake does, he goes through some thorny area, and somewhere that thorn pricks, and then he comes out of that skin, and the skin is without the snake inside. And thereafter, as the air goes inside that skin sleeve, with the movement of the air, that skin sleeve appears to be moving. Is it a snake there? No. In the same manner, the wise man appears to be living in the body, but he is no more living as the body. He has already transcended the limitations of the body. Therefore, as long as the breathing is going on, the life is lived. Therefore, wise people are far above the achievements and failures in life. See, friends, if we really want the best guidance in our life for our spiritual evolution, go to a master who doesn't have to do anything in this world. He alone will guide us properly. If we go to somebody who has some projects in his mind, I have to, build a Shiva temple. Shiva never told him. People never told him. It is the khujli. You know, the word khujli cannot be appropriately translated in English. English, it means itch. But itch doesn't give the force of khujli. So it is one's own khujli. I want to build the Shiva temple. And then anybody who will come and meet me, what I will do? I will try to see how this meeting is encashed in terms of getting some donation money. We have gone there to get some spiritual advice. And what we get? If you donate, this temple will construct in your name. This temple was constructed by Gadvadananda. See, friends. In this world, there is nothing that is worthy of me. See, friends. Therefore, the wise man lives in this world like the skin cast off a snake appears to be enlivened by the movement of the air, but it is already dead to the world. In the same manner, the wise man lives in this world, but no more as a person, but as the principle expressing through the body. Itastataha chalyamano yatkinchit pranamayuna srotasaniyate dao yato nimmos tatastalam. Like itastataha chalyamanaha yatkinchit pranamayuna. Like as long as the breathing goes on, his life continues. Charayvedi, charayvedi, keep on moving. See, I'll tell you a very good experience. I came from Australia, Melbourne, to Bombay. And within 24 hours, I had to catch another flight to go to London. So my friend, he came to receive me at night. 1 o'clock I came out, 1:30. It was raining. And afterwards, I went home with him. He asked me on the way, Swamiji, why are you running so much? Come by one flight, go catch another flight. What are you doing it for? You have no answer, you have no projects, you have no school, no college. Why are you running like this? I said, okay, I cancel everything. And from now onwards, I will stay in your house 24 hours. No, I don't mean that. See, friends, in this world, keep moving, keep. Before anybody has to tell us, how much do you charge to leave this place? We should have the wisdom to withdraw from the world. And when we don't have this, then we start suffering in this world. So in every family, old people are a problem. Why they are a problem? Because they get involved in the lives of the children, whether invited or uninvited. You have already destroyed your life. Now let them destroy their life. Why do you want to destroy their life also? Let them have that much freedom. And then we feel bad. Today's children, Swamiji, we were not like that. Why are the children not like this? Then I tell them, I said, look here, we were lucky. We have good parents. You got the reply? See, friends. Therefore, wise men never stay in any place holding on to a person or a project. Keep moving. And itastataha chalyamanaha pranavayuna. Till the body is living, keep serving this world without expecting anything out of it. Example, srotasaniyate daru yato nimnot natasthalam. Like, you know, the wooden log is being carried away by the river. It goes up and down like the water flows. In the same manner, sometime comfort, sometime discomforts, sometime honor, sometime dishonor, sometime wonderful food to eat, sometime nothing to eat. I'll tell you my one experience, terrible experience. This happened in Fiji. We reached the place in some guest house they have kept us. No light, no nothing. And at about 12:30 or so we reached. And we had not taken food for earlier for 24 hours. And when I reached there, I thought there will be something to eat. Nothing was there to eat. And I was dying of hunger. So I opened the fridge and no light, no nothing. So I just put my hand and I found there is a bread. I said, there is a bread in there. So I opened that and ate 3-4 pieces of bread. And no water, no nothing, slept. Next day morning, the host came. Swamiji, how about this night? Did you sleep well? I said, yes, it was perfect. Then, what would you like to have? I said, something to eat, I am hungry. Okay, we'll open the fridge. They opened the fridge. And they said, take this bread and I'll get butter. I said, okay, open the bread and I'll take it. And when they opened the bread, it was all green and yellow fungus. Yes. As if it was a spread of fungus, thick. And that I ate last night. When I saw that, the lady said, no, no, Swami, don't eat this. This is poisonous. It is already gone inside. See, friends, to whom will you complain? See, friends, if we live in this world with this clear understanding, it is the Lord's will, which is making everything happen. Wise man is living in this experience. And therefore, Srotasa Niyate Daru. Daru means wooden law. Sometime comfort, sometime discomfort, sometime good, sometime bad. Daivena Niyate Deho Yatha Kalo Pabhuktishu Laksha Lakshagatim Tyaktva Yatishnet Kevalatpana. Now what is the wisdom with which this wise man is living? Daivena Niyate Dehaha. He knows that the body is being taken care of by the divine will. Be very attentive. Those who are caught up in this karma, 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 they all the time talk in terms of, I don't know what was my prarabdha, I got married to this lady. Prarabdha karma. Second thing, Swamiji, because of my punya, I was able to meet you. Because we are lost in this karma, we always talk in terms of cause and effect. A wise man does not talk in the language of cause and effect. For him, everything is happening as divine will. Daivena Niyate Deha. And therefore he has no complaints. See how important it is. Like, many of us say, Swamiji, maybe because of our punya we met you. It is wrong. See, Tulsidas ji writes in his Ramcharitmanas, Binu Hari Kripa Mile Nahi Santa. If saints and sages come in our life, it is not a karma phala. It is the divine blessings. Because of karma phala, we get only two. One is joy and second is sorrows. Joy and sorrows are the effects of karma. But coming in satsanga, coming in the contact of the wise people, it is not the result of our karma. It is Ishvara Anugraha Teva Pumsam Advaita Vasana. It is by the divine grace alone we come on this path. And if we have come on this path by the divine grace, where is I? I am doing this, I am doing that. See, friends. Therefore, Daivena Niyate Dehaha. What is required for the body, the Lord will provide. There is no doubt about it. And Yatha Kaloka Bhuktishu, Yatha Kala, whatever time, whatever is required, that perfectly reaches us till date. See, friends, only what is required is our complete recognition of the divine intervention in one's life. And Laksha Laksha Gatim Tyaktva, and therefore, for this wise man, there is nothing to be achieved and nothing to be protected. भगवत गीता 9th चैप्टर अनन्याश्चिन्तयन्तो माम ये जना पर्युपासते तेषां विद्याभियुक्तानां योगक्षेमं वहाम्यहम्। भगवान सेज दोज हु आर फुल्ली डेडिकेटेड टू मी एंड मी अलोन इन ऑल द टाइम प्लेस एंड सिचुएशंस आई टेक केयर ऑफ देयर रिक्वायरमेंट्स एंड आई प्रोटेक्ट देम योगक्षेमं वहाम्यहम्। वी सिंपली से wise people live that experience and therefore they are no more living as the body, they are living through the body. So yatishtet kevalatmana, he is living as a pure conscious existence. See friends, be attentive. The electrical energy goes through the bulb as light. There are two bulbs. One is illuminating the temple, other is illuminating the toilet. Now we start talking. This bulb which is illuminating the temple must be a punyatma. He must have done lot of merits in the last life. Therefore, he has come to the temple. That bulb. Mahapapi, he has to illuminate the commode, the toilet. Then one day, the bulb in the temple becomes fused. Why this happened? Because God likes good people. Bad people are left on the earth. Anyway, yeah, it's okay. Now we have to do aarti, we can't see anything. What about the lamp? What about the bulb? Anyway, remove that bulb from the bathroom and fix it here. We remove that and fix it in the temple. How come this bulb has come here? Because some merits must have surfaced. See friends, when the light of the bulb was illuminating the Lord, or the light of the bulb was illuminating the toilet, the light was not influenced at all. When our eyes see red color or green color, eyes are not influenced. The rule is, the illuminator is never influenced by what is illumined. See friends, therefore, this wise person yatishtet kevalatmana. So let any experience come and go. Every experience is illumined. But no experience can ever touch him. And therefore he has no complaints. Everything is perfect. Shiva eva swayam sakshat ayam brahma vidurtamaha jivanneva sadamuktaha krutartho brahma vittamaha. So such a great master, Shiva eva swayam sakshat ayam brahma viduttamaha. The best among the knower of the reality, who is abiding in this absolute, he himself is sakshat paramatma. See friends, be attentive. We cannot experience electricity without its effect, without its manifestation. Whether there is electrical current or not, how do we know? Only when we see the effect. And what is the effect? We fix the bulb. If the light comes, yes, it is there. In the same manner, Paramatma is manifested through these great masters. And therefore, he is none other than the Paramatma. Like the light in the bulb is nothing but the manifestation of electrical energy. See friends, therefore, one has to clearly understand, be very attentive. Our journey is from vyakti, individuality, to abhivyakti, manifestation, to abhivyakta, that which is manifesting. Our journey is from the world which is illumined to the bulb, from the bulb to the light, from the light to the electrical energy. This is the path. And now see here. It doesn't matter what we hear. It doesn't matter what we see. Because our faculties are not influenced by what is seen or heard. Similarly, it doesn't matter what thoughts come in the mind. Let any thought come by, worry about it. Similarly, let there be any experience, waking, dream, deep sleep or samadhi. All of them are mutually exclusive. When waking is there, the other three are absent. When dream is there, the other three are absent. When deep sleep is there, the other three are absent. When the samadhi is there, the other three are absent. But there is one principle which is in and through all the waking, dream, deep sleep and samadhi experiences, but it is not corrupted by any experience. That is our essential nature and that is the Paramatma. Where is the place for desire fulfillment? Where is the place for going to the hell and heaven? Where is the place for pranayama and do shirshasana? It is only correcting our focal length. When we go to the eye doctors, they don't give us vision. Vision is already there. Because of whatever reason, our eye muscles have become important to adjust the focal length. And therefore, things appear very ambiguous, mixed up. We can't see them distinctly. But when we go to the doctor, what he does? He gives us a number, a glass, and these glasses help us in adjusting the focal length. Vision is not created by the doctor. In the same manner, by our karma, yoga, prana, Paramatma is not created. It is already there. But our focal length is not adjusted. Adjust your focal length and come to discover that mai eva sakalam jatam, mai sarvam pratishtitam, mai sarvam layam yati, tad brahmadvayam asmiham. Everything is born in me. Everything is existing in me. Everything goes back in me. That one reality, which is the substratum of creation, sustenance and destruction, but which is beyond creation, sustenance and destruction. That is our essential nature. In this manner, laksha laksha gatim tyaktva yat tishtet kevalatmana. For such a wise person, there is nothing to do, nowhere to go. Then life is just a time pass. Take this principle, friends, with you. If you want to transcend the limitations of time, live life as a time pass. Whenever we live life as a time pass, I is not born. When I is not born, then there is no victory or defeat. There is no gain or loss. There is no joy or sorrows. Sukadukhe same krutva labha labho jaya jayo tato yuddhaya yujjasva naivam papam avapsasi. Because there is no doer. See, friends. So, Shiva eva svayam sakshat ayam brahma viduttamah jivanneva sada muktah krutartho brahma viduttamah. And then what is the quality of experience of this wise man? Jivan eva krutarthaha. Bhagavad Gita 15th chapter. एतद् बुद्ध्वा बुद्धिमान् स्यात् कृतकृत्यश्च भारत. We all have tried to fulfill our desires, but we have not attained fulfillment in life. Wise man has attained fulfillment in life. And when the life is fulfilled, there is nothing to be achieved. There is nothing to be protected. See, friends, if we have got one sankalpa in our head, we can't even sleep. Suppose you have to catch early morning flight and you have to go 2-3 hours earlier. So you calculate, so let me finish my dinner quickly so that I can sleep and get up and finish my bath and I'll go to the airport. You finish your dinner quickly, go to bed quickly. But in that 3-4 hours of sleeping time, you look into the watch 300-400 times. One sankalpa destroys your whole night. How many sankalpa we have got? Himalayan sankalpa destroys our total life. The joy of the wise man is, see, prajahati yada kaman sarvan partha manogatan. He doesn't live in this world under the compulsion of desires, but he is living in this world under the intoxication of inspiration. The performance of an inspired person is different, and the performance of a person working under compulsion is different. See, a person who is owning a business, the way he works, and those people who are working in his own shop or factory, they work, there is a difference in the quality. See, friends, therefore, जीवन देव सदा मुक्तः कृतार्थः जीवन ब्रह्मवित्तमः. सो अवर अटेंशन शुड बी नॉट फुलफिलिंग द डिजायर्स बट अटेनमेंट ऑफ फुलफिलमेंट इन लाइफ. एंड फुलफिलमेंट कैन कम ओनली इफ वी हैव कंटेंटमेंट. पतंजलि महर्षि राइट्स, संतोषात् अनुत्तम सुखलाभः. कंटेंटमेंट इज अनपैरेलल्ड ब्लिस. We have always something to be added. Everything is fine, but the moment the but comes, life is destroyed. Can we ever say, yes, it is perfect? We don't want any change. It's a question of how we train. See, friends. Therefore, jivan neva sada muktah kritartho brahma vittamah. उपाधि नाशात् ब्रह्मैव सद्ब्रह्माप्येति निर्द्वयम् शैलूषो वेशसद्भावा भावयोश्च यथा पुमान्. ओ ब्यूटिफुल. शैलूषः एन एक्टर ऑन द स्टेज, वेदर ही इज पुटिंग द कॉस्ट्यूम ऑफ ए वॉरियर or he has removed that costume of the warrior and he is an ordinary person, a husband, does it make any difference to that man? It makes no difference. In the same manner, for the wise man, whether the body is living or the body drops, he who has already recognized that although I am acting on the stage as a warrior, but I know I am a miserable husband of a terrible wife. So I will play my role beautifully well, get the applause from the public. But in the heart of my heart, I know you may clap here, but when I go, I get a slap. You don't know. See, friends, the wise man is ever living in this experience. Therefore, there is no posthumous God realization. After you die, you will go to heaven. Don't get cheated by these false promises. Similarly, if you do this thing, you will go to hell. Don't get frightened by these threats. One person came and asked me, Swamiji, I don't want to go to hell. I said, don't go, it's not compulsory. Swamiji, you don't know what sins I have done. You say, you name, and I have committed that sin. And with those sins, I am definitely going to hell. So please protect me. I said, look here, my friend, I told you, you will not go to hell. How come after doing so many sins? I said, because where are you now? Somebody can go to hell if he is not in the hell. You are already there. A person who does not have fulfillment in life, he is living in hell. See, friends, fulfillment in life is the ultimate. And what is that fulfillment? We have nothing to achieve, nothing to lose. Equanimity is never corrupted. Living in that experience 24/7, effortlessly. See, friends. And this can very easily happen if only we learn from our experiences. But the main problem is we don't learn from our experience. Then even Sakshat Bhagavan will come. We will not learn from him. So what is the real spiritual practice is learn from your own experiences. See? And therefore, this wise man, Upadhi Nashan Brahmaiva Sat Brahmapeti Nirdvayam. While he was living through the body, he was establishing the reality, and when the body is discarded, he has nothing to do, nowhere to go. Upanishad says, na tasya prana utkramanti. Be attentive. You know, there are two paths. One path is the path of liberation through stages. Second is now and here, or nowhere. And which are those two paths? Liberation through stages. If you do this thing, you will go to Indra Lok, you will go to Varun Lok, you will go to this Lok and that Lok, and then you will go to Brahma Lok, and there Ramaji is conducting satsang. When satsang was conducted here, we were sleeping. In Brahmaji, satsang will be awake. See? And after that, then Brahmaji will continue satsang. At least you get here tea, then you won't get tea. In Brahma Lok, there is no tea. See, friends. And then when Brahmaji is dissolved, you will be liberated. Don't get lost in that. Therefore, here is very clearly said, you are that. Now you have whether the body continues or drops, it makes no difference. When a pot breaks, will the pot space go out in another pot? Think. When the body drops, everything is. But then what is said in our scriptures, you know, that Suchi Inam Sri Matam Gehe Yoga Vrashto Vijayate Atha Yogi Nam Eva Kule Bhavati Dhimatam Etat Hi Durlabataram. What is said is what you think that you are. If you think you are a sinner, you are a sinner. If you think you are a meritorious, you are a meritorious. If you think you are a body, you are a body. If you think you are a soul, then keep on doing the soul curry. And if you recognize you are that infinite, non-dual, absolute, conscious, blissful reality, nothing in this world will ever touch us. See, friends, therefore, Bhagavan Shankaracharya has not built his samadhi anywhere. No samadhi. Panchadashi, if you study, there's very clearly brought out, for the wise man established in this non-dual reality, it doesn't matter where the body falls. Whether on the banks of Ganges or in a gutter, he has already destroyed and discarded the body before the body falls. Examples are given like the garland that is put in the neck of a cow. The cow will not take care of the garland, whether it falls or it is destroyed, who cares? In the same manner, the wise man has already disowned the body, and therefore, upadhi nashat brahmaiva sat brahmapyeti nirdvayam. He comes to get established in this non-dual before even the destruction of the body. Naturally, the body destruction is not a big event. Just like an actor, when he removes his costume, nothing is lost. When he puts on the costume, nothing is gained here by him. Tathaiva brahma visreshtaha sada brahma iva naparaha gade nashti yatha vyoma yoma iva bhavati swayam. See, the same example. Tatha eva brahma visreshtaha, the best among the knower of the Brahman. Means what? There are different degrees of Brahmavid. The first degree is, they know there is Brahman. You know, there is one very beautiful story in Panchadashi. If you really want to get established in the truth, study Panchadashi. That will shake you. No doubt will be allowed to remain. If somebody is a Christian, if he doesn't know Bible, how can he be a Christian? In the same manner, if somebody claims to have studied Vedanta and doesn't know Panchadashi, it is an incomplete understanding. Panchadashi takes all those possible doubts that a human mind can entertain, and those all possible doubts are answered, analyzed. After studying that, even if you want, there cannot be any doubt. This doubtless understanding is the first step. Then the second step is, this doubtless understanding is to be experienced. So, one starts working in that line. This is the second step. The third one. Now, one is established in this experience. It is no more heard from somewhere, told by somebody, no. It is now immediate, aparokshanubhuti. Like we have this experience of our presence. We don't go and ask anybody, hey, excuse me, am I present? No. Our presence is not authenticated by anybody. Brahma visreshtaha, this one. So, tathaiva brahma visreshtaha, sada brahma eva na aparaha, is ever living as absolute, although functioning through the relative. From his point of view, the relativity has no existence. We talk about north, east, west, south. And therefore we get influenced by Feng Shui. But from the spaces point of view, there is neither north, nor east, nor west, nor south. And what is this north, east, west, south? Two conditionings are brought in between. The earth and the sun. So that direction where sun rises is called as east. And where the sun rises? In east. Which is the east? Where the sun rises. So the east is because of the sunrise, or the sunrise is because of the east. And we get lost in that. Unless we discard all these conditioned expressions, we will not be able to cognize this unconditioned reality. With this knowledge, if you just look within, you will see whenever we are disturbed always as somebody. And somebody is a temporary phenomena. That absolute conditioned by some conditioning is called as somebody. Man conditioned by the father is called as son. Man conditioned by the wife is called as husband. Reality is man. The son, the husband, the father, these are conditioned expressions of the man. And who is miserable? Man is never miserable. And conditioned expressions are never happy. So what is to be done? Play the role. Before father, if you go, play the role of the son. Before wife, if you go, play the role of a submitted servant. Before the son, if you go, listen to whatever he tells. If you want to remain happy. But what happens? In front of the father, we start teaching father. Dad, you don't understand anything. You are digging your grave. You go before your wife as a husband and start expecting she should understand. If she would have understood, she will never marry you. Understand this. All the miseries are to these conditioned expressions, not in the absolute. Therefore, the real spiritual life is only Rama Leela, Krishna Leela. Leela is what? Where everything appears to be happening, but nothing is happening. See? How simple it is. You all know Ramayana. In Ramayana, this was not known even to Lakshmana. Only Bhagwan Ram and Sita ji knew. When they left Chitrakoot, Bhagwan Ram told Sita ji, now you hide your original form, enter the fire, and a Xerox copy of Sita comes out. And that Sita ji, who was following Rama thereafter in the forest, was not the original one, it was a Xerox copy. Lakshmana didn't know that. And Sita, which was abducted by Ravana, was not the original Sita. It was only Xerox copy. But how did Rama behave? Oh, my darling Sita is gone away. Who has taken? He knew it was a Xerox copy. And yet, what a beautiful acting. And after, he went and killed Ravana. And then, when Xerox copy came, what he told to the Xerox copy? Now, go back Xerox and let original come. See, friends. So all that Bhagwan Rama did in the forest, it was just a drama. See, friends. There is only one way to answer your all questions. And then one way is take life as a mega drama and don't be the audience, be the actors. An actor is the one who pretends to be something but is never that. See? But instead of acting in the life, we react. Actors get name, fame, money, publicity, everything. Reactors get kicks. Therefore, act in life. When you go before your wife, act. Honey, without you, my life would have been most miserable. With you, it is terrible. But this sentence you said in the mind, don't say loudly. You must know who is said that to say. Life will become such a great fun, friends. Instead of acting in life, we keep on reacting, and the reactionary lifestyle is the cause of misery. Therefore, Brahmaiva Brahma Visreshtaha Sada Brahmaiva Naparaha. He is never living a single moment as an individual. 24/7. See, our spiritual practice is half an hour before the God, that time we are devotee. And after that, dhum dhadaka suru. Our spiritual practice is half an hour meditation, suffering silently in the darkness. I don't know. These people don't listen to me. Meditation. These are the cartoons of meditation. Let there be no disturbance. Keep quiet, everything. Everything quiet. And you say, and then in your bathroom, the water drops on a plastic bucket. Tuck. Oh God, these people, I don't know why, don't continue. Tuck. Tuck. Bhagwan disappeared. And tuck, tuck, you start concentrating. Tuck. And then it stops. Oh, water is gone. Meditation. Friends, when nothing in this world disturbs us, and it is not to be done, it is our natural state. Like this example I give a dozen times, eyes illuminate all colors and forms, but eyes are not influenced. Ears hear every kind of sound, but ears are not influenced. Mind entertains every kind of theme, noble, ignoble, divine, devilish. But mind is not influenced by them. In the same manner, the conscious reality that we are supports waking, dream, deep sleep, samadhi, but none of them ever touch this reality. We don't have to do anything. That is our real nature. Only come to cognize this is what it is. See the beauty. It is not doing anything. The spiritual practice according to Upanishad is not doing, it is undoing. It is not becoming somebody, it is unbecoming. We have become a lot, unbecome everything. See, one day, one young boy, IT fellow, you know, these IT fellows, they don't know how to look at human beings because all the time looking at the monitor and all options. And slowly, slowly, they come to a point that life is a mouse and a click. Once I received one SMS. The SMS was, why Lord Shiva and Parvati could not learn computer? So I replied, I don't know. Reply came, because Ganesh ji took away the mouse. Person, he asked me this question. Swamiji, can you tell me the simplest way of spiritual practice? Then I asked him. I said, when data is created on your hard disk, exactly what happens, you tell me. And when we delete the deleted data, where does it go? Have you ever seen? Exactly the same way. All these are only images. When these images we start giving a status of reality, we are lost. And therefore, here the teacher says, Tathaiva Brahma Visreshta Sada Brahmaiva Naparaha. He is ever the same. Never anything else. Never give any option to yourself. We give so much option. Sometime happy, sometime miserable, sometime miserable, sometime more miserable. Instead of that, remain untouched by this. This is all the spiritual practice. Effects. So, this person who asked me this question, can you tell me some shortcut method? What you told is okay, but shortcut. I can understand, you know. I said, okay. You are an IIT fellow? He said, yes. Many a times, your mobile phone gets hung up. And you are unable to do. So what should be done? I don't know. I said, I'll tell you. Go to the settings and click factory settings. When you click the factory settings, your phone comes to the original normal settings. Exactly. Go back to the factory setting as we were born. We were born as nobody. Go back. These are the factory settings. But because there is a free download, we keep on downloading all garbage. And we don't understand. After downloading, you have to install. We don't install and we complain. I don't know what is happening. You have to install that knowledge. See, friends. So going to satsang is like downloading the free satsanga. And thereafter, you have to install it in your system. And then only it will become activated. So to do that, what is the first step? Get back to your factory settings. And doing that means undoing all what we have been doing. See, friends. Life is not difficult, it's not complicated. We make our life complicated. There is nobody responsible for that other than ourselves. And if we are the culprit creating problems for ourselves, we have to sort them out. Nobody can do it for us. Please remember, we have to live our life. We have to die our death. And on the spiritual path, there is nobody who can do spiritual practice for us. There is no proxy on the spiritual path. You have to do it yourself. And what is that doing? All undoing. How beautiful it is. And for that undoing, I'll give you one or two simple techniques. Try. Technique number one. Never talk of your past, nor ask anybody about their past. You will start living in the present. If you observe, what we talk is only about the past. And what we talk, when we were children, things were different. Naturally. What is great about it? One person in Calcutta met me, very elderly person. So, he says, Swamiji, where from you have come? I said, I came from Vrindavan. Before coming to Calcutta, I was in Vrindavan. Oh, Vrindavan has changed so much, Swamiji. When we used to go, it was totally different. Now it is completely changed. It is not the same Vrindavan. I said, Dadaji, look into the mirror. You have also changed. You are not the same. Earlier you used to put on dhoti, now you have come on pant. Earlier you used to put on a pagri, now you have got a golf cap. Earlier you used to eat the paratha, now you like the pizza. See, friends, constant change is the only unchanging reality of this world. There is nothing to discuss about it. But all the time talking about the past, we give a reality to the past and then start imagining that the total summation of my total past is I. Try this. If you decide not to talk one word about your past and not to worry about the future, you come in the utter present. You have to do nothing to remain silent. You are in samadhi. Mind doesn't want to die. Therefore, it goes on feeding either the memories of the past or trying to solve the non-existing problems of the future. Curtail these two occupations of the mind dies. Because mind cannot exist in the utter present. You are not doing anything. The mind makes us dance. Either think about the past or worry about the future, and in the present compare. Three things you drop: past memories, future worries, and comparison in the present. Your mind will disappear. Mind will merge in consciousness. Thought-free mind is consciousness. Consciousness contaminated by the thoughts is mind. It is as simple as this. Come to recognize and go for a bush walk. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam.